Hello dear students, today I am going to deliver a lecture on the topic range of thallus in green algae. Algae are chlorophyll containing thallophytes which are characterized by the non-presence of embryo stage and presence of non-jacketed gametangia in which all cells are fertile. Algae are usually aquatic. Their body structure ranges from unicellular colonial filamentous, pseudoparenchymatous to parenchymatous forms, but they are thallophyte plants because their body never forms true roots, stems and leaves. The thallus is always non-vascular. Presently, algae are treated as a division and divided into 11 classes. Among these 11 classes, Chlorophyceae, which is also known as grass green algae, are of special interest because they are one of the largest and diverse groups of algae with more than 425 genera and 7000 subspecies. They are of great evolutionary importance because they are considered as ancestors of true land plants due to the fact that both the green algae as well as land plants possess the same type of chlorophylls, that is chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Similar cellulose and pectin compounds in the cell walls and starch as the common storage carbohydrate. The thallus range in green algae is very diverse, ranging from unicellular flagellate forms, for example Chlamydomonas, unicellular non-flagellate forms, for example Chlorella, flagellate colonies, for example Volvox, non-flagellate colonies as represented by Hydrodictyon, cyanocytic and siphonaceous forms, for example Calorapa, heterotrichous forms, for example Drupernaldia, to parenchymatous forms, for example Vulva. Unicellular algae are the most primitive, while heterotrichous algae are the most advanced forms in green algae. General characteristics of green algae. Chlorophyceae is characterized by the presence of chlorophyll A and B, starch as reserve food, and pyrenoids, which are surrounded by starch sheath. They possess cellulosic cell wall. Sexual reproduction ranges from isogamous to oogamous types. The thallus ranges from single unicellular motile form to complex heterotrichous form. Most of the green algae are aquatic, about 90% of which are freshwater. Chlorophyceae have been divided into 9 orders: Volvocales, Chlorococales, Eulotricales, Cladophorales, Chitophorales, Edogonales, Conjugales, Siphonales, and Charales. All the members of Edogonales and Conjugales are freshwater. Members of two groups, Siphonales and Vulvaceae, are marine. Most of the Volvocales, Cladophorales and Chitophorales are found in both freshwater and marine waters. Eulothrix is found in damp soil in the form of sheets. Sexual reproduction in green algae occurs by isogamy, anisogamy and oogamy. The sex organs are usually unicellular. Zygote represents the diploid phase. The life cycle in different genera may be haplontic, for example Chlamydomonas, diplontic, for example Caudium, isomorphic, for example Cladophora, or heteromorphic, for example Urospora. Range of thallus structure in green algae. Green algae show great variation in the vegetative organization, life cycle and habitat than any other group of algae. There is great variation in thallus structure in green algae, which ranges from simple but primitive motile unicells to complex but highly evolved large multicellular forms. Thalli vary from a few microns to several feet in length. The most primitive and simple thallus is represented by their motile unicells. All the other forms of thalli can be derived from motile unicellulars as motile colonies. They are formed when motile unicellulars combine together loosely. In fact, this is the first line of evolution in algae. This is called the Wallacean line and culminates in Wallax. Non-motile colonies. When the motile cells lose their flagella and combine together, a non-motile colony is formed. This line of evolution is called the chlorococcine line. Filamentous forms. If the cells are held tightly by middle lamella after transverse divisions, a filament is formed. Membranous body. It is formed when the orientation of the cell division is controlled precisely such that all the new walls occur in only two planes. A thin sheet of cells is thus formed. Parenchymatous body. If the cell divisions occur in all the three planes, a bulky three-dimensional parenchymatous body is formed. Siphonaceous body. If the nuclear division is not followed by cytokinesis, multinucleate cells get formed. This is the siphonalian line of evolution. The different kinds of thalli of green algae can be described as follows. Unicellular thallus. It comprises of a single cell and is the simplest thallus which can be motile or non-motile. Motile unicellular thallus. Such algal forms are unicellular, spherical or oval, and flagellated. For example, Chlamydomonas and Haematococcus. Chlamydomonas is a unicellular motile algae which has a spherical or ellipsoidal body with two flagella placed at its anterior end. Non-motile unicellular thallus. Such algae are unicellular but lack flagella, eye support, and contractile vacuole. They are also called coccoid forms, for example, Chlorella and Chlorococcum. Now, colonial thallus. If the unicellulars adhere together loosely, the resulting structure is a colony. All the cells are simple and unspecialized. The colonial thallus may be motile or non-motile. Motile colonial forms. When a definite number of flagellate unicellulars unite together, they form a motile colony. It may consist of 4, 8, 16 or more flagellated unicellulars united by mucilage. All the cells of a colony are physiologically independent and each resembles Chlamydomonas and behaves as one unit. If the cells in a colony are definite in number, arrangement and have an anterior-posterior polarity, the colony is called synobium, for example, gonium, Wallax and Pandorina. Gonium colony contains only a few cells and the only sign of being organized is that all the flagella beat in a coordinated fashion. Pandorina is of about the same size as gonium but is more advanced because some differentiation of cells between the anterior and posterior end has taken place. In Wallax, synobium is spherical and consists of about 50,000 Chlamydomonas type biflagellate cells. It is visible to the naked eye. Here I must clear the fact that Wallax is a multicellular colony but not a multicellular individual because individual cells in the colony coordinate only for the movement of the colony. Otherwise, they show complete individuality or non-interdependence in the matters of nutrition, respiration, and other life-supporting activities. Wallax on maturity shows polarity because it shows two different types of cells, namely Chlamydomonas type cells, which constitute about 90% of the colony, are present in the anterior part, and gonadal cells, which constitute about 10% of the colony, are confined to the posterior part of the colony. Now, non-motile colonial forms. If the unicellulars lose their flagella or do not develop flagella and then aggregate together, a non-motile colony results. For example, Hydrodictyon. A mature colony of Hydrodictyon consists of elongated cells joined together end to end to make polygonal shapes. These cells are cenocytic and contain many nuclei. The whole colony is a hollow cylinder that can grow up to 75 centimeters in length. Since whole colony of Hydrodictyon resembles a net, this algae is also called water net. Siphonaceous or cenocytic thallus. Some single-celled algae elongate to form a non-septate, multinucleate, tubular or sac-like structure. This condition is called cenocytic condition, which is the result of karyokinesis without cytokinesis. For example, Caudium, Calorapa, and Vicheria. The latter has a long branched cenocytic and siphonaceous thallus. The thallus is aseptate and the septa are formed only at the time of reproduction or at the site of injury. Internally, there is a siphon-like central vacuole which gives the order the name siphonales. Acetobacteria is a siphonaceous algae which consists of a stalk ending in an umbrella-shaped cap. The stalk bears the only nucleus present in the thallus. In Calorapa, a large cenocytic thallus consists of a branched creeping rhizome and erect assimilatory shoots of various shapes. Now the filamentous thallus. It results if the cells are held tightly by middle lamella after multiple transverse divisions, that is, when a unicell divides several times in a single plane, a filament is formed. If the filament cells undergo longitudinal divisions, the filament branches. The filamentous forms are of following two main types. Simple filament. Such type of filamentous thallus consists of a straight row of cells. In Spirogyra, the cells are arranged from end to end in a single row or file. Such filaments are unbranched. In Eulothrix, the cells are arranged in a single row as in Spirogyra. But it has a rhizoidal cell at one end by which it gets attached to the substratum, and at other end it has an apical cell. In Edogonium, there is division of labor between various cells. It shows apical basal polarity. The thallus is a long unbranched filament. This alga has a rhizoidal cell for attachment. The filament consists of green vegetative cells which are photosynthetic, cap cells for cell division, superspecialized Anthidia and Ogonia for reproduction. Now branched filament. If some cells in a filament divide in a second plane, that is longitudinally, a branched filament results. The branches arise from the main axis as lateral outgrowths. Best example is furnished by Cladophora. It shows bush-like thallus and is attached to rocks. The individual cells are large, multinucleate and cylindrical, placed end to end. The thallus is attached to the substratum by rhizoidal outgrowths arising from the base of the plant. In Agagropila group growing in water, rolling wave action leads to the aggregation of young branches to form balls floating on water. Cara-like forms. It has a plant-like body. It resembles equestrium in having nodes and internodes on the axes. From the nodes arise three types of appendages. Branches of limited growth. These branches arise in whorls of 6 to 16 at the nodes of the main axis. They stop their growth after some time. They are also called primary laterals, leaves or branchlets. Reproductive structures are born on these branches. Branches of unlimited growth, also called axillary branches. These branches arise from the axils of the branches of limited growth. They also bear nodes and internodes. besides a whirl of primary laterals at the nodes. They grow indefinitely, stapelodes. The basal nodes of the branches of limited growth develop some unicellular outgrowths called stapelodes. Main axis shows apical growth. The plant is attached to the substratum by a well-developed rhizoidal system. Nightila has Kara-like habit. Now, foliaceous thallus. A membranous or foliaceous body results if the cells of a filament divide in two planes, that is, transversely and longitudinally. Such forms appear as green paper sheet, for example, vulva. It has a lettuce leaf-like shape, hence called sea lettuce. Basal part of the thallus forms a stalk. Now, massive parenchymatous thallus. If the cell divisions occur regularly in all the three planes, a bulky three-dimensional parenchymatous body results, for example, enteromorpha. Now, heterotrichous filament. Heterotrichy means presence of two types of branching, prostrate branching forming the prostrate system and erect branching forming the erect system. It is the most highly evolved and advanced type of thallus. It is found in the cheetophorales. The prostate system creeps along the substratum and sends rhizoids to fix the thallus. From the prostate system arise the upright filaments forming the erect system. In some algae, both the prostrate and the upright system may be well developed, for example, Cetigeocolonium and Fritstila. In Coleochaete alga, the erect system is reduced to a few hairs. In Cheetophora, the erect system is better developed. In Fritstila, the prostate system consists of a rounded cluster of cells buried in the mud. While the erect system consists of two regions, a lower primary projecting system and upper secondary projecting system. By modification of the heterotrichous habit, the other thalli were formed. In Drapernaldia, the prostrate system is reduced to hold fast and the erect system is differentiated into main axes from which lateral branches arise. In Drapernaldiopsis, the main branches bear short and long cells alternately. Nodes and internodes are also present. The main axis is meant for support where the laterals perform photosynthesis and reproduction. Dear students, this was all about the range of thallus in green algae.